We want to study from universe, huh? Galaxy. Chalo. A very good day, everyone. Let us start without wasting the time. Until now, what we have done? Yesterday's audio will be shared to you till evening. There was some glitch due to my phone. I'm not going to share that. So in the evening, I will be sharing you the yesterday audio that we have recorded for the revision purpose. Okay? I'm not audible.
Audible? Yeah.
Sure. So now we are going to start with again the revision part first. First 10 minutes only for the quick revision that we have done till now. First of all, we have done, there should be international transaction and everyone should pay attention because revision matters a lot. Quickly keep your videos on. Point number one. Point number one is there should be an international transaction and international transaction should be between two or more associate enterprise. Okay. What is associate enterprise? Associate enterprise, two or more associate enterprise and at least one should be a non-resident. Remember? Now, when at least one should be a non-resident, what is associate enterprise? The associate enterprise has been given where in section 92A, they have given us the details about associate enterprise. When one enterprise holds another enterprise 26% or more voting power, whether directly, indirectly, that is associate enterprise. Or when one enterprise holds another enterprise 26% or more, and there is a common holding. It is holding for it also 26%, for this also 26%, for both are what? Associate enterprise due to common holding. Then when one enterprise gives loan and advance to other enterprise, that is 51% of the book value of the asset of other enterprise, both are said to be associate enterprise. When one enterprise gives guarantee and guarantee is 10% or more of the total borrowing of another enterprise, it is said to be associate enterprise. When one enterprise is wholly dependent on know-how, patent, copyright of the another enterprise, it is said to be associate enterprise. And when one enterprise appoint majority of the board of director, majority of board of director of other enterprise, it is said to be what? Associate enterprise. When one enterprise fulfills 90% or more of the raw material requirement and price is influenced by the other enterprise, then it is said to be associate enterprise. And when one enterprise manufactured the product and it sells to other enterprise, but the price is decided by other enterprise, it is said to be associate enterprise. You are getting the recall over there? Then, when one enterprise does what? When one enterprise is either your AOP, BOI, HUF and 10% or more of the profit sharing or interest you are getting from that enterprise, their associate enterprise. When one enterprise is controlled by individual and other enterprise controlled by same individual, it's relative or relative plus individual, then these are said to be associate enterprise. Then when one enterprise is by HUF and another enterprise is also controlled by HUF or its member or by relative or the members of HUF, it is said to be associate enterprise. So we have done what? What is international transaction in section 92B? Then we have done what is associate enterprise in 92A. Then now, this international transaction between two or more associate enterprise should be at arm length price, and arm length price is nothing but your market value. How to determine the market value have been given in section 92C, ki what are the market value, how to calculate market value. 92C has how many methods? 92C has cup method, that is comparable uncontrolled price method. It has cost plus method. Now, cost plus method is nothing, direct indirect cost plus markup percent you have to add on. Then retail sales price method, we have done that when one associate enterprise sells to another associate enterprise and that associate enterprise resell the product, we have to do the back calculation to calculate the cost. Then it was profit split method. In profit split method, there should be a genuine ratio. On the basis of that, you will be distributing the ratios. You will be distributing the profit. You will try to distribute profit at place where taxes are low. So therefore, they are saying ki profit to be distributed on genuine ratio. And then there is transitional net margin method, that means what industry is doing, you have to just adopt that. We call who are? Now, after this methods, we have done certain questions. That was example we have done in from our period. Now, they are saying if suppose you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up to 5 arm's length price. That means different unrelated parties say you have done a transaction. Only up to 5 you are having. So which arm's length price will you choose? Will you choose minimum? Will you choose maximum? Or what? So they are saying if up to 5, always take what? Average. Average will be your the arm length price, but if this average and your actual transaction price, the difference is only up to 3%, do not worry whatever is your transaction price, that is deemed to be your arm length price because 3% ka benchmark they have allowed. But this 3% is when it is trading. If you are doing trading, then it is what 3%, but if it is wholesale, in case of wholesale, it is what 1%. In case of wholesale, it is what 1%. And what is wholesale? When you purchase finished goods, when you what purchase finished goods and you spend total cost ka 80% or more on those finished goods, in that case, it is your wholesale or your average monthly closing stock coming to be less than equals to 10% of your sale, less than or equal to 10% of your total sales of the month. In such a case, it is said to be wholesale. Now, suppose in my data set, I'm not having 5, I'm having 6, 7. That means total 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That means above 5, I'm having the observation what I will do. In such a case, they are saying what you have to apply. You have to apply the range concept. When it says you have to apply the range concept, remember you cannot apply which method? You cannot apply profit split method because profit is already certain. Itna profit hai. Just ratio you need. So you cannot apply profit split method for range concept. Understood? Then, if I am having ma'am 7 as the number of arm's length price, so your first step should be arrange that in ascending order. What you should do, you should arrange them in ascending order. After arranging in ascending order, 7 ka 35% you have to do and 7 ka 65% you have to do. After doing 35%, 65%, whatever is the number, for the time being, I'm assuming this is coming to be the number for the time being. Now, this is fraction. If it is fraction, round it off to 1, that means 3. Do not do 2 because you will think mathematically it is not possible. 2.3 is not 3, but here it fraction will be rounded off to 1. Here it will be what? 5. Now check 1, 2, 3. You would have already adjusted this arm length price in ascending order. What is written in front of 3 and what is written in front of 5? This is the starting range and this will be your end range. If your transaction price fall between this range, then transaction price is arm length price, but ma'am, it is not falling between the range, then take 50% of 7, that means 3.5. And now what is written in front of 4, that is your arm length price. I hope you recalled that what we have done yesterday. Ma'am, now we have 20 numbers in the data set. We have how many numbers? 20 numbers in the data set. That means when I will, if you have 20 numbers, first of all, again do what? Arrange in ascending order. First of all, you have to arrange again it in ascending order. After arranging in ascending order, again do 20 ka 35% and 20 ka 75%. Now, ma'am, 20 ka 35% and 20 ka 75%, suppose it is coming to be 7 and it is coming to be 30. Ma'am, it is whole number. Suppose it is coming to be 7 and it is coming to be 13, ma'am, it is whole number, now it is not in fraction. So 7 ke baad kya aata hai? It is 8, after 13, it is 14. So check the arm length price before 7, check the arm length price before 8, check the arm length price before 13, check the arm length price before 14. Take the average of this arm length price, take the average of this arm length price, whatever is the answer, this is your range. If your transaction price falls between the range, then it is your transaction price is arm length price. But if transaction price does not fall between the range, in such a case, again, take what 20 ka 50%, That is coming to be 10. Now 11. What is written in front of 10? What is written in front of 11? Take an average of it, and this is your arm length price. Understood? Now, after this, what we have done, that they will, for this range concept apply to current year and to previous year. Remember, it applies to current year and to previous year. In such a case, how I will do? So they are saying take average. If they have given GP, take the average of 3 years ka GP. Simply add year one ka GP, year two ka GP, year three ka GP. Just add it. And sales, if they have given sale year one ka, sale year two ka, sale year three ka, add and calculate the weighted GP. Now your weighted GP for first observation, second observation, third observation, fourth observation, fifth, sixth, as the case may be, you will get the observation. And this, all the percentage you will get, again, arrange them in ascending order and apply that 35%, that 65%. If fall between the range, okay. If not falling between the range, do 50%. Understood? Now, in that 3 years, ma'am, we find ki there was a company named A. Suppose the company named A. Now, it is of no use to us. You can remove that company. Ma'am, a new company has been introduced and we find that it is useful for the calculation of all these things. The new can be introduced and that is not relevant. That can be removed. No issues in that. So, this was all about the concept of what a range concept that we have done yesterday. I guess everything would have been recalled now. Any query on that? Kuch bhi query hai? Nahi? Aage badh ja. Aage badhe. Chalo. So now we are starting with the another concept. And the concept is your appa. The concept of what? Appa. What is appa? That is advanced pricing agreement. One more thing we have done. Now, again, coming to the revision, we have skipped something that was related to, generally, you calculate your arm length price. Okay. And AO accept whatever you have given. But there are four cases when AO say, I will be the one who will be calculating your arm length price. The case number one, when most appropriate method has not been followed. If you do not follow the most appropriate method, then AO will say, I will be calculating your arm length price. You have chosen most appropriate method, but the data is not reliable, not correct. Again, AO will calculate. Third, you have not at all maintained the documents. Or you have maintained the document, but you failed to furnish those documents. In all these cases, it is deemed that AO is going to calculate your arm length price. Now, suppose AO going to calculate your arm length price. But what will happen? If AO going to calculate your arm length price in such a case, suppose AO done it, okay. But AO unable to do that, then he will refer that to transfer pricing officer. You have to refer it to the transfer pricing officer. And after referring it to transfer pricing officer, either the assessment would have got completed. If it got completed, additional 1 year, fresh 1 year you will get. If assessment is not completed, you will get plus 1 year. Now, transfer pricing officer has to complete the assessment and at least he should give me before 60 days of the end of the assessment order. But ma'am, he was able to give me only 40 days before. I will add 20 days to make it 60. Given me 30 days before, I will add 30 days to make it 60. Given 10 days before, I will add 50 days to make it 60. That means extension is possible up to 60, not exact 60, to make it to the extent of 60. Transfer pricing officer has given the decision. Is the decision binding on SEC? No, not decision is not binding on SEC, but the decision is binding on AO. Suppose during the assessment, transfer pricing officer finds something new. For AO has given an assessment and in that nothing was mentioned about that transaction. But during the assessment, he found something new transaction. Can TPO give decision on that transaction? Yes. Even a new thing is found, he can give that. He can give decision or order on that transaction also. If something is not binding on SEC, that means SEC has the remedy. he can go for appeal, he can go to DRP. What is DRP? Dispute Resolution Panel. Something is there, but we know he is having some remedies. What about my department? Generally, department do not have anything, but revision ka concept is there. Now, revision ka concept, where it will be applicable, we cannot discuss right now. That will be discussed in my assessment procedure. But something is there. If it is prejudicial to the interest of revenue, they have only one option in such a case. Understood? Chalo. So this was the complete revision. Now we are moving to next segment, that is APPA. APPA is nothing but your advance pricing agreement. Now, what do you mean by advance pricing agreement? What do you mean by advance pricing agreement? Advance pricing agreement. When it comes to advance pricing agreement, understand one thing. When it comes to advance pricing, advance before a transaction, advance mein you want to decide, you want to know what would be the pricing. So advance mein you want to know what would be the pricing, and for that an agreement is done, that is known as advance pricing agreement. Understood this? Normal. Ki advance pricing is, in advance I want to know what could be the arm length price, for that I want to do an agreement. But this agreement with whom? This agreement you do with CBDT. This agreement you do with CBDT, and with CBDT you do the agreement, but approval of central government is needed. So this is an agreement with board. Board, with the approval of central government, entered into advance pricing agreement. Understood? Now, why this advance pricing agreement that we call as APPA, why it is entered? It will determine your arm length price. In advance, you are entering, and they will tell, for this similar type of transaction, your arm length price will be 300. Your arm length price will be 700. That means predetermined arm length price. So for the purpose of determining arm length price, you can enter into APPA. Or what would be the manner in which I will be identifying my arm length price? Remember, you have 5 methods. You have to choose most appropriate method. Now, suppose you find ki cost plus is also applicable to you. You find ki suppose comparable is also applicable to you. Kind of transaction is that 2-3 methods you find all are appropriate. Or suppose transaction is such that you are unable to decide, any method is not completely suitable. So what you will do? You will enter with the approval of central government with board, and they will give you the manner that how you will determine your arm length price. Understood? Now, not only for arm length price or for the manner of arm length price, nowadays section number 9, that is your deemed to be accrued income. Income accrued or deemed to be accrued is given in section number 9. Right now you have not done that, but in inter you at least know something is deemed to accrue income. So what would be your deemed to accrue income? For that also APPA can be entered. But no rules have been yet given. Only they have mentioned ki for determination of arm length price, for the determination of manner of arm length price, and to determine what? And to determine section number 9. What is your income deemed to accrue arise in India? For this 3 purpose, APPA could be entered. Any doubt till now? Now, this was the base. Now, the main thing is, there should be international transaction. Only and only if you have international transaction, then only you can enter into APPA. Ma'am, what about specified domestic transaction? Remember, more than 20 crore wala? Only international transaction. International transaction includes deemed international transaction. That means only for the purpose of international transaction you can enter into APPA, otherwise you cannot enter into APPA. Done? Now, if you want to enter into APPA, if you want to enter into APPA, whatever method appa will give ki this is the manner you have to follow, only this manner to calculate arm length price, then it has to be only that manner. That means now 92c, your cup method, your retail sales price method, that is not applicable. So whatever range concept you apply, that is not applicable. Only the method appa will, that means appa override, appa is an overriding effect. Understood? Maximum 5 years ke liye you can enter into appa. Can I enter for 4 year? Yes. 3 year? Yes. 2 year? Yes. 1 year? Yes. But maximum is 5 year. You cannot enter for 6, 7, 8 year. Maximum 5 years you have to enter into appa. That means till now whatever I have explained, this was not having any logics. It was completely ki ye hota hai. Now entering into the zone of logic. When it is valid, it is valid for 5 years. To on whom it is binding? If appa has taken a decision, okay, appa has taken a decision, the decision of appa is binding on whom? So first thing, the person who enters into appa. I am the person who has applied that I want to get enter into appa, so I am the person on whom appa is binding. So appa is binding on the person who enters into appa. Now suppose I have entered into appa for a particular transaction. Now my brother says we have similar kind of transaction. Mere brother ka same transaction, and he also want ki whatever decision appa has taken for you, I can also apply because transaction is very similar. No, it is binding on person who enters into appa. My brother cannot adopt that same decision. It is binding on particular transaction. I have taken appa for laptop. Now I cannot apply appa ke decisions on computer. Are you getting? So it is on particular transaction, it is on particular person, and it is also binding on, it is also binding on commissioner, IT authority, that is income tax authority, and the person who has entered into such transaction, we have already done. So it is binding on CIT and all the subordinates below CIT. Subordinate below CIT is GC, additional commissioner, assistant commissioner, deputy commissioner, inspector. CIT pe you have CIT, then you have CCIT, that is chief commissioner of income tax. On all this appa is binding. Appa is binding on income tax authority, CIT, PCIT, CCIT. On all this appa is binding. Itni pehle baat samajh mein aayi? That means ma'am, is appa binding on ITAT? You remember, you know the hierarchy. Do you know the hierarchy? Sabse pehle it is your income tax authority. After income tax authority, you will go to whom? You will go to ITAT. That is your income tax appellate tribunal. So they are saying ki appa is binding. Appa is what binding? But appa is binding on what? Appa is binding on commissioner. Appa kahan pe binding hai? Appa is binding only on commissioner, on who are subordinate to him. Who are what? Subordinate to him. That means above commissioner, if I talk about CBDT, if I talk about ITED, appa is not binding. It means if appa has given any decision, if any decision is given by appa, ITED can change that decision. Are you getting? Arm length price calculated as per appa. ITED find, no, this is not the correct arm length price, it can revise. But appa has calculated an arm length price and CIT finds ki yaar, this is not correct. As per appa, the decision is not correct. I find ki appa ka decision for arm length price is not correct. CIT cannot revise it. Getting? Itna, this thing you should write down in your language. Giving you 2 minutes to write it. Binding nature. Done. Sure. Now, so they are saying appa is binding on a particular person, appa is binding on particular transaction, appa is binding up to the level of CIT, up to the level of CIT. But not to ITAT, High Court, Supreme Court, it is not liable to, it is not binding on them. That means whatever decisions are taken by APA, ITAT can revise those decisions. Done? No. Ma'am, when APA is not binding, suppose for 5 years I have entered into APA. After entering for 5 years, what happened? After 3 years, law changed. Now, actually, APA was entered for 5 years. But in between the law changed. So if there is change in law, your APA will not be binding now. Now the facts of the transaction changed. Previously it was only laptop business you was entering into. It was only laptop business. Now you have discarded laptop and only computer desktop you are entering. So your facts have entirely changed. So now you cannot apply laptop wala arm's length price, a laptop wala APA to here computer. So that's why if there is change in law, if there is change in fact, it is not binding from that date. But ma'am, this is different, not binding. And what do you mean by void ab initio? You would be knowing that thing. What do you mean by void ab initio? Simple.
Starting se hi galat hai na.
Starting से ही गलत है means from the very start it was something that was not acceptable. अब वो कैसे पता चलेगा? Now department that is board come to know that they have entered into APA by fraud and misrepresentation of the fact. ठीक है void from the beginning right? तो they have entered due to fraud by fraud or misrepresentation of the fact तो APA altogether void. अब समझना मेरी बात ध्यान से. You have entered into APA for how many years? You have entered into APA for 5 years. This is my 5 years ka timeline. Year 1, year 2, year 3, year 4, and this is year 5. Theek hai. Till this 2-3 years have already passed. Already how many years passed? This 3 years has already passed. And you were not aware that actually it was fraud and misrepresentation of the fact. That means when you are not aware that it was fraud, misrepresentation of fact, that means in this time, you have calculated arm length price as per APA, right? You have calculated arm length price as per APA. But now, when here, you came to know that it is fraud, misrepresentation of fact, that means from here, would you apply APA? No. You will say no. From now, APA will not be applicable. No, no, no. Itna samajh mein hai? Itna you got to know? No. Hua kya? When you come to know ki from this date, APA will not be applicable. That means normal provisions will be applicable, right? Normal provision kya mein wo 92C. Because APA is not applicable now, 92C, 92C arrange concept, whatever, normal provisions will be applicable. And as per normal provision, your arm length price will be calculated. But they are saying the time that has already been elapsed, the time this time has already been elapsed, gone. and here you would have calculated your arm length price as per APPA. Here revision is required because it is void ab initio. Starting say galat, right? It is starting say wrong. So here I have to revise this APPA. So they are saying when we want to revise the APPA, you have to exclude this time for the purpose of assessment order. When you want to give the assessment order, you should ignore this time. Which time? This time should be ignored. Ma'am, why only this time to be ignored? Why not this time we are ignoring? Are you understand the logic? Because APPA is not applicable here, already normal provisions will apply. Where I have to make the changes? I have to make the changes only in this area. So I should exclude only this time na, mujhe sirf isi time ko exclude karna chahiye na. So if you want extension of time for the assessment procedure, so extension of time should be from the date you have entered into APPA and the date you come to know it is fraud misrepresentation of fact. Only that time period you exclude. Exclude means increase the time period for us for assessment, because that time we have to revise it. We have to apply normal provisions now. So here what has been written? See, void ab initio. If board with the central government approval has entered into APPA, later on they find ki APPA entered by fraud or misrepresentation of fact, they will declare it void. And if they declare it void, all the provisions of the act apply as if agreement was never entered. Itna bhi samajh mein? All the provisions will apply as if it was never entered. Now period of entering into APPA and end date of the order, that order ki now APPA will not be applicable. Can I say when you come to know about the fraud, the date you come to know about fraud, the date you will say ki now APPA will not be applicable, exclude that time period. Why exclude? Because that extra time we need, because revision is required now. So assessment procedure you will do. In assessment procedure, we need this extra time. Why we need this extra time? Because only in this duration, revision is needed. Understood this concept? Because students get confused, why we are excluding this? We are excluding this because already when it was this time period, yahan ke time period mein toh waise bhi aage se normal provision will be applicable. Repeating in Hindi now. Aage se yahan jab tumhe pata chalta hai ki fraud hua hai, आगे से तो तुम वैसे भी नॉर्मल प्रोविजन अप्लाई करोगे, तो क्यों चाहिए तुम्हें एक्स्ट्रा टाइम? तुम्हें तो पीछे वाले टाइम को देखना है ना, जब तुमने नॉर्मल नहीं अप्पा अप्लाई किया था, रिविजन तो यहाँ चाहिए ना, तो एक्स्ट्रा टाइम इतना ही तो चाहिए तुमको. अंडरस्टूड? समझ में आया?
मम्मी लास्ट वाला दोबारा तुम बोलो.
ठीक है, आई एम जस्ट रिपीटिंग इन हिंदी. सलादी, यू गॉट इट द कॉन्सेप्ट? So I'm just repeating in Hindi. देखो हुआ क्या, ये हमारा timeline है, ठीक है? This is our timeline. कितने साल के लिए हम APPA enter करते? For how many years we enter into APPA? For at least हम भी मानते हैं कि हम भी कितने years के लिए enter किया APPA में? 5 years के लिए हमने APPA में enter किया, कर लिया, अच्छा लगा, सब कुछ अच्छा चल ही रहा था. लेकिन फिर क्या हुआ, यहाँ पे कितने इयर्स अच्छे निकल गए? सपोज 3 इयर्स, वेरी गुड. कुछ भी पता ही नहीं चला कि फ्रॉड मिसरिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द फैक्ट है, कुछ भी पता नहीं चला, राइट? कि फ्रॉड है, मिसरिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द फैक्ट है. नाउ जब उन्हें पता ही नहीं चला फ्रॉड मिसरिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ फैक्ट है, तो क्या अप्लाई किया होगा? दे वुड हैव अप्लाइड अप्पा के कॉन्सेप्ट. एंड रिमेम्बर, जब अप्पा के कॉन्सेप्ट अप्लाई होते हैं तो उन्होंने कहा था ना 92C, 92CA, ये सब अप्लाई नहीं होता है. क्या ये अभी पढ़ा था, ये याद है कि व्हेन अप्पा इज एप्लीकेबल यू कैन नॉट अप्लाई दिस. दैट मींस कैन आई से इन नॉर्मल टर्म, नॉर्मल प्रोविजन एप्लीकेबल नहीं होंगे अगर अप्पा एप्लीकेबल हो रहा है तो. अगर अप्पा एप्लीकेबल है तो नॉर्मल प्रोविजन को भूल जाओ. मैम ये जो हमारा टेन्योर चल रहा था ना, यहाँ पे नॉर्मल प्रोविजन एप्लीकेबल नहीं होंगे क्योंकि अप्पा एप्लीकेबल था और हमें पता भी नहीं था कि फ्रॉड मिसरिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द फैक्ट है. यहाँ तक कोई डाउट? चलो फिर हम आगे बढ़े. थोड़ा सा हम जैसे आगे बढ़ते हैं तो उन्हें यहाँ पता चल गया कि फ्रॉड मिसरिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ फैक्ट से तुमने अप्पा में एंटर किया, तो जब तुमने फ्रॉड मिसरिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द फैक्ट से अप्पा में इंटर किया, नहीं 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 मतलब अब अप्पा के कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं लगेंगे, वॉइड एब इनिशियो हो चुका है, शुरू से ही गलत है ये, बिल्कुल रिवाइज करो सब कुछ, क्या करो रिवाइंड करके दो हमको। इसका मतलब शुरू से गलत का क्या मतलब हो गया? शुरू से गलत का सिंपल मतलब ये है कि अब यहां से तुम्हारे लिए अप्पा के प्रोविजन नहीं लगेंगे, क्या लगेगा? नॉर्मल प्रोविजन। तो एक चीज बताओ, जब तुम वैसे ही नॉर्मल प्रोविजन अप्लाई कर रहे हो तो यहाँ कुछ एक्स्ट्रा कर रहे हो क्या? यहाँ तो कुछ एक्स्ट्रा कर ही नहीं रहे ना, नॉर्मल प्रोविजन अप्लाई कर रहे हो ऐसा मान के कि अप्पा कभी था ही नहीं। तो मुझे रिवाइज कहाँ पे करना है? मुझे रिविजन सिर्फ चाहिए कहाँ पे? मुझे रिविजन चाहिए सिर्फ इस जोन में, ये जोन है जहाँ पे रिविजन नीडेड है। तो तुम काम कितना टाइम एक्स्ट्रा मांगोगे? बोलते ये जो टाइम है ना, सिर्फ इस टाइम को तुम एक्सक्लूड कर दो, ये टाइम को क्या करो, एक्सक्लूड कर दो हमारे असेसमेंट से। हम पहले क्या मानेंगे, ये जो 2 साल है ना, इस 2 सालों का फिर से असेसमेंट करना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि अभी इस ईयर का असेसमेंट भी अप्पा से हुआ था, इस ईयर का असेसमेंट भी अप्पा से हुआ था, अब हम पे इसको भी नॉर्मल प्रोविजन लगाना है, इस पे भी नॉर्मल प्रोविजन। तो ये टाइम हटा दो, ये टाइम 2 टाइम का असेसमेंट हुआ ही नहीं पहले, तो ये मान, आर यू गेटिंग नाउ? क्योंकि अब हमको इसका रिवाइज करके फिर से असेसमेंट करना होगा इस पर नॉर्मल प्रोविजन। अंडरस्टूड सचिन? तो कॉन्सेप्ट बहुत छोटा है, वो एक्चुअल में कुछ भी नहीं है, सीधे बोल रहे हैं कि जहां पे रिवाइंड करना है तो मान लो कि असेसमेंट अभी हुआ ही था, क्योंकि तुम तो बोल रहे हो ना शुरू से ही गलत है, जब गलत है तो फिर से करना पड़ेगा, तो वो टाइम पीरियड मानेंगे असेसमेंट नहीं हुआ तो उस टाइम पीरियड को हटाओ। नाउ व्हाट सचिन, बड़े आगे?
ओके मैम, जो फर्स्ट 2 ईयर की जो असेसमेंट होगी तो उसके लिए अलग से टाइम मिलेगा?
वही ना, अब देना पड़ेगा ना, क्योंकि तुम तो निकल गए आगे, 3 साल बाद की कहानी आ गई। अब तुम बोल रहे हो पिछले 3 साल का फिर से रिवाइंड करो, तो पहले तो मानो कि गया वो हुआ ही नहीं, फिर उसके अकॉर्डिंग हमको टाइम पीरियड चाहिए। ठीक है,
ओके मैम, ओके,
गिव मी 1 मिनट। डन? कितना डन? नाउ वी हैव डन द रेंज कॉन्सेप्ट, आई एम गिविंग यू ओनली 5 मिनट्स टू राइट द रेंज कॉन्सेप्ट, क्या था वो, उसमें सारे स्टेप्स लिखो, देन वी विल कंटिन्यू। रुको मैं टाइमर लगा रही हूँ। Tell me who is having first attempt and who has already given at least one or two attempt of DT, IDT, group two.
First attempt
group two. Saladi. Quickly, don't wait for me for the personal interview. Tell me. First in November 23.
For me also it will be first.
Yeah?
For me also it will be first.
TT first attempt. Sachin, you have given, na? Yes. I guess you were also asking queries somewhere, sometime on WhatsApp.
Yes.
Because you have not changed DP since long, therefore I know this is you. In last to last attempt also, I guess you have either called me or something. Just for the doubts. No, no, I have WhatsApp your chat. Which attempt is this?
No idea. I mean, November my first attempt. Yeah.
Voice is very low.
First attempt, November.
This is second attempt?
Maybe second attempt.
This is second attempt. What was there? Was your aggregate lacking or any particular subject?
Aggregate also and paper 6 also.
Paper 6 exempt?
Anyone?
Can you share me your results? So basically, we will plan. See, as we are going for mentoring also, I have to plan accordingly for you also. Because you have already appeared. Na? And Saladi, as it is almost a year for you, almost. Don't even think that once you have completed DT, IDT, you can stop doing that preparation. Because DT and IDT, you will forget. In fact, whatever is the subject, whether it is FR, whether it is FSM, whatever is the subject, you will forget. You have to maintain the continuity of revision. Okay, so maintain that continuity of revision, otherwise batches will be, any of the batch will be zero for you. Okay, and DT, you can ask from any student. Just by completion of the class, they will forget. Ki kya tha? Phir khud hi karna padta hai, aisa ho jata hai. Okay. Now, what is the purpose of making you write small topic that we have done at least bina dekhe ek baar mere saath likh lo. That's why any time between 10 minutes, I will allot you for writing daily. So daily you have to write. Okay. And that you should not mix up. That will be a log copy where you will be writing that at least you would know ki kuch to bhool rahe hai. So tum log pick kar lena ki what you are forgetting. Theek hai? Chal. Kyunki khud se to tum nahi likhoge, ye to main janti hu. Now, what is rollback provision? Abhi tak kya chal raha tha? It was, we will enter into upper. It was what? We will enter into upper. Is there any disturbance? You are getting any disturbance? No? Okay. Is that ki you are entering into upper. Theek hai. Upper maximum how many years? 5 years ke liye you can enter into upper. Now, this 5 year is future ke 5 years. This 5 years are future ka 5 years. But now there is the concept of rollback provision. Rollback, are you getting rollback? All the years that have been elapsed. The years that have been what? Elapsed. So now, suppose this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years. So generally you enter into APA, generally you enter into APA for maximum how many years? For 5 years. Okay. But now if you have entered into APA, focus my word. If you have entered into APA, you may means it's not mandatory. You may choose to go into rollback provision. You may choose to go into the rollback provision. That means this APA is entered for future years. There is the concept of rollback. And you may enter into rollback. And that rollback is allowed for 1, 2, 3, 4 years. So only 4 years. For maximum 4 years, you can choose. What? You can choose rollback provision. For maximum how many years? 4 years. You can choose the rollback provision. Now, question number one. Now, as I have entered into APA, ठीक है? As I have what entered into APA, APA is entered for how many years? Now, APA is entered for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years. So, is it compulsory for me to enter into rollback provision for 4 years? Or can I choose, I want only 1 year ka rollback provision, or I want only 2 years ka rollback provision, or 3 or 4. Is it my choice? Because in APA, I have choice, either 2 years, either 1 year, either 3 year, either 4 year, or entire 5 year, that is my choice. Maximum is 5 year. But would I have the same choice? Would I have that same choice when I am going for rollback provision? So first answer is, rollback provision mein, you have to compulsory apply for 4 years. You have to compulsory apply for how many years? You have to compulsory apply for 4 years. That means rollback provision for entire 4 year, you cannot choose. I'm not saying you will get rollback provision. Mark my word. I'm not saying you will get rollback provision, but you have to apply for 4 years. Your application should mention how many years? 4 years. Whether they will give you rollback or they will not give you rollback, that depends on CBDT. But your application should be for how many years? Your application should be for 4 years. Done? Now, question number two. Ma'am, I do not want to enter into APA. Because for future transactions, I don't think I want to enter into APA. There will be no use. But I just want to enter where? I just want to enter where into this rollback provision. Can I do so? I do not want to enter into APA, but I want to get entered into only rollback provisions. Is it possible? Answer is no. If you want to enter into rollback, compulsory you should have first entered into APA. APA ke baad rollback hota hai. Rollback ke baad APA ka provision nahi hai. So if you want to enter into rollback, compulsory APA you have to enter, then only possible. Theek hai, aaya samajh mein? Now, second, ma'am, I do not want to enter into rollback. I do not want to enter into rollback, but just what I want to do, I want to enter only into APA. Is that possible? Yeah, that is possible. You can either choose APA and rollback or only APA, but you cannot do only rollback, no APA. That is not possible. That means if you want to enter into rollback, APA chahiye. APA ke saath you can do rollback, but only rollback never possible. But only APA is possible. Understood? Itna hai? Chalo. So question number one was, is only APA possible? Yes. Only rollback possible? No. Have I been given any choice from 4 rollback? You can enter for 3, 2, 1. No. Have I given choice in APA 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? APA mein you can go for 4 years, 3 years, 2 years, 1 year. But maximum is 5 years. So APA mein you have choice. Rollback mein compulsory your application will be for 4 years. Itna aaya samajh mein? Now, what is the condition? There might be some condition if you are saying you want to enter into APA. There should be condition. Kuch to conditions hongi hongi. So ma'am, what are the condition if I want to enter into a rollback? So they are saying, if your international transactions for which you have entered into APA. Here you have entered into APA. If the international transaction for which APA has been entered, the same international transaction is here also. That means transaction should be same. If international transaction is here, and whatever international transaction you are doing here, if both are same, then only rollback is possible. Otherwise, rollback is not possible. Kyunki tumhara international transaction to kam se kam same hona chahiye. To itna jo humne padha pehle, usko read kar lete hain. Sabse pehle. Rollback provision. For any period, you can enter the rollback provision, but that should not be more than 4 preceding previous year. we will understand what is this preceding previous year, but yes, only 4 years you have to understand now. The rollback provision you can enter, but only for 4 years, not more than that. Is it mandatory? Yes, mandatory rollback 4 years, either do not take it. Either take 4 or take none. Then, rollback of only those previous year. Now they have given conditions. What are the conditions if you apply for the rollback? What are the conditions? Now, another condition they have given. If you want to take rollback, you just make an application that these are the 4 years I want to make rollback. But they will allow you rollback for only those years when you have filed the return of income of that year by due date. If that is belated return, rollback not applicable for that date. Remember what I have told you. You must apply for 4 years. Tumko 4 years ke liye apply karna hai. But what if they allow you rollback provision for entire 4 year? Nahi. Sabse pehle, if you want to apply, check. Have you filed previous 4 years ka return, all 4 years ka return on or before due date? If you have filed on or before due date, apply, 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 apply. Ma'am, for this year, I have not applied. I have not filed the return on time. It is a belated return. Rollback provision will not be allowed for this. Second, condition number 2. If you want to apply for rollback, suppose in previous year, your assessment has already been decided by ITAT. ITAT, kuch to yaad aa raha hai. Previous year mein your assessment was there and your assessment has already been decided by ITAT. Ma'am, ITAT ne decide kiya to kya hoga? ITAT pe binding nahi hai aapka. And already been decision given by ITAT. So now what is the logic of rollback? Already disposed. ITAT has disposed your assessment order. Ki ye hoga tumhara. When I have ITAT has already taken the decision and appa ke decisions are not binding on ITAT. When higher authority have decided something, for that rollback will not be applicable. Understood this two concept? Third, because of application of rollback, your income is reducing below your return of income. Whatever you have given in your return of income, your income is 100 crore. Due to the application of rollback provision, what is happening? Because of the application of rollback provision, your total income is reducing. Would they apply this rollback provision now? For that year also, rollback provision will not be applicable. 4. International transaction in APA and the international transactions that I have entered in rollback, not same. Rollback provision not applicable for those years. That means you will apply for 4 years, but they will now check whether ITAT has passed any decision, whether it is reducing your total income, or whether it is your previous year ka the return and you have not filed on time. So if any of the situation is getting complied, rollback will not be applicable for that year. You will apply, but rollback will not be applicable for that year. इतनी चीज समझ में ना मैम एज यू सेड यू हैव टू फर्स्ट एंटर इनटू अप्पा देन ओनली रोल बैक विल बी अलाउड अंकिता अरोरा हैज एंटर्ड इनटू अप्पा ठीक है अंकिता अरोरा हैज व्हाट एंटर्ड इनटू अप्पा आई डोंट हैव एनीथिंग आई हैव एंटर्ड इनटू अप्पा दिस इज सपोज एग्रीमेंट आई हैव एंटर्ड इनटू अप्पा नाउ आफ्टर एंटरिंग इनटू अप्पा आई वांट रोल बैक सो दिस शुड बी अंकिता अरोरा हु वुड बी टेकिंग rollback. Then company X entered into APA. Company X entered into APA. Now the company X have been merged with Y company. Company X merged with Y company. Now it is XY company. But who has entered into APA? Company X. Now company XY want to enter into rollback. Is it possible? The person who has entered into APA, only that person can enter into rollback provision. Ma'am, it was company X entered into APA. And now the company has been demerged. Now the company, suppose X is different and the part has been different. Now can they enter into APA? The company X who has entered into APA, it can take role back. But the demerged part, suppose now the name of the demerged part is Y. Y had to separately enter into APA, then only it can take role back. Are you getting the logic? The person who has entered into APA, only that person will take role back. If there is merger, new company form, first of all, new company has to enter into APA, then only rollback will be possible. Demerger, the demerged company, okay, the resulting company freshly enter into APA, then only rollback possible. But demerged company can enter in, has already entered into APA, rollback possible for demerged company. You will apply for 4 years. All the 4 years rollback are previous year return to be filed on or before due date. But if not filed on or before due date, rollback not applicable for that year. Ma'am, due to application of rollback, my total income is reducing. Not at all possible, rollback nahi milega. Ab phir se. This is rollback ka year. Abhi maine bataya tha, this same concept I have told. This is rollback wala year 1, 2, 3, 4. Theek hai? Now this is rollback ka year, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. For the year number 2, suppose ITED already passed the decision disposed by ITED. So would you say rollback applicable here? Rollback milega ke yahan pe? No, nahi milega. But now the condition is yahan pe for third year also my assessment is pending before ITED. ITED has to give order, but what I am saying, word pending. Now I am not saying it disposed. Ab kya word bola maine? Ki here my assessment is pending before ITED. Have ITED taken any decision? Abhi ITED ne koi decision nahi liya. Right now ITED has not taken any decision. When ITED has not taken any decision, for this time, can you enter into rollback for this year? Yes. Because they say if disposed, then we cannot enter. If pending, rollback could be entered. Understood this? Understood? Chalo. So, rollback only for those previous year when the return of income has been filed on or before the due. Done. No rollback if order have been passed by whom? ITED has already passed the order. Application of rollback cannot reduce your income that you have mentioned in return of income. Now analysis number 2. You as an SSC filed your return of income. ठीक है? You as an SSC filed your return of income. ध्यान से सुनना इसको. This is your return of income. ROI. You have shown your total income as suppose 100 crore. Done? Itna samajh mein? Return of income file 100 crore. I have shown that this is my total income. Later on, thoda sa I am going into detail. Even you don't know assessment procedure, but I have to for this purpose. Now, after filing the return of income, AO studied your return of income and find ki there are certain things that he is unable to understand. He done scrutiny. At least you understand the meaning of scrutiny. He does scrutiny, all the evidences he will check, and on the basis of scrutiny, that is known as assessment. That is known as what? Assessment. Now he says your income is 125 crore. ठीक है? Now this is what your return income. Return income means what you have mentioned in your return. After scrutiny, AO increased your total income and he is saying it is 125 crore. ठीक है? Now you are not satisfied with the decision that is taken by whom? You are not satisfied with the decision that is taken by my AO. In such a case, what you will do? In such a case, you will do appeal. Obviously, CIT of appeal or whatever. You will do a certain appeal. You don't know where the appeal is, but at least you understand the word ka meaning appeal. You will go to appeal. After going to appeal, suppose the decision now comes and decision says ki actually the total income is 110 crore. Now you are applying all appa ke provisions. You have done appeal after the appa ke provisions, everything. After applying appa provisions, everything, or applying rollback provision, now they are saying actually your total income is 110 crore. It is not 125 crore. Is it possible? Yes or no? You have shown 100 crore. From 125 crore, they said your income is 110 crore, not 125 crore. This reduction due to appa, is it possible? Appa applied, rollback applied, whatever it is. Or transfer pricing ke provisions applied, as the case may be. Now they are applying the provisions and saying your income is 110 crore, not 125 crore. Is that possible, correct or not?
Impossible, ma'am, because we are not reducing the income. It is the department who reduces.
They are reducing now from 125 crore, reducing to 110 crore.
Yes.
Is it possible? Socho. Read this sentence now. Read this sentence.
No, ma'am. Because here it is mentioned as any return of income, which was 100. So it is not going below 100. So, yeah.
Here it is clearly mentioned that it cannot reduce income below what is mentioned in your return of income. Remember, I have circled it also. So when reading, I'm trying to give you the mistakes of your reading. When you do random reading, you are not going to get the things. You have to focus on word ki what they are saying. Now clearly they have told one thing ki below return of income you cannot reduce. And this is, I told them, this is not return income. This is assessed income. Ye to assessed income hai. They can reduce assessed income by applying appa ke provision, rollback ke provision. But they cannot reduce it below 100 crore because you yourself has written ki 100 crore is my income. Now I can go into the detail also. You can also revise the return. You can also revise your return. You know the concept, there is a revision. Saladi, pay attention here. You know, there is revised return. Now if you have revised the return and done 80 crore, then it cannot reduce below 80 crore. Are you getting? So return, maybe you have revised return. So if revised return you have filed before the appa ke all this thing, then it would be 80 crore. So it cannot reduce below 80 crore. So return means not only normal return, it could be a revised return also. Understood? Now this thing, write down properly in your language and give me that paragraph, whatever you have written. Let me check how you will frame this on this thing. Likho. Saladi, write down quickly.
Only rollback or the
entire? No, only this concept that okay. Reduce income below wala. Elaborate this concept. When you have done it, raise your hands. There is an emoji over there. I will understand that you have done this. Take your time.
Ma'am, only this previous point. Ma'am.
Yeah, only the concept of return of income that you have to elaborate with example. Done. Sachin, you can send me. Sachin has taken 4 minutes to write that. What about Rajesh ji and Saladi?
Done.
Not Sachin, it was Karthik. Done? Likhte raho. Just note down your time, the time you are taking to write this. Saladi, done? 5 minutes. Rajesh, you done?
Yes, ma'am, sent.
When you have stopped, what was the time?
It cost 4 minutes. 4 minutes.
Sachin, no photograph. Karthik, no photograph.
Done.
5 minutes, 40 seconds.
I'll send the PDF now.
So while timer, whenever you will write something, also start with the timers. See, suppose on an average you are taking how many minutes? 5 minutes, right? On an average, 5 minutes you are taking to write a very small. Agar ye question aata hai, suppose a case study has been framed on this. Obviously, it would be hardly of 3 marks. इससे ज्यादा तो नहीं, 3 to 4 marks का ये क्या होगा, केस स्टडी होगा, नॉट मोर देन दैट. सो सपोज नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द टाइम मैनेजमेंट. 5 मिनट्स यू आर टेकिंग एटलीस्ट फॉर आंसर्स ऑफ 4 marks. ठीक है, 5 मिनट्स यू आर टेकिंग. ओवरऑल टोटल हाउ मेनी क्वेश्चंस यू हैव इन डीपी का पेपर ओवरऑल, टेल मी. कभी थोड़ा समझाओ, ऐसा लगाओ कि देख लें कितना आता है. ओवरऑल कितना होता है टोटल? 20. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 पूरा हो गया. क्वेश्चन 2 में दे हैव 3 पार्ट्स. क्वेश्चन 3 में 3-4 पार्ट्स एटलीस्ट. तो मिनिमम आई थिंक से मिनिमम पे जाते हैं पीपल. लेट्स से ओनली 15 क्वेश्चंस आर देयर. मिनिमम आई एम टेकिंग 70 मार्क्स का डिस्क्रिप्टिव. यू हैव मिनिमम 15 questions. Now 15 into 5, can you do 15 into 5? That will give you 75 minutes. What do you mean by 75 minutes? 1 hour. Okay, that is what, 1 hour plus how many minutes? 15 minutes. Is it possible you will write in 1 hour 15 minutes entire thing? Because in 15 questions, 4 marks के क्वेश्चन विल बी लेस. तो ऑन एन एवरेज आई हैव टेकन कि चलो 1.5 घंटे में यू वुड बी राइटिंग. इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 वी हैव नॉट टेकन, दैट इज एंटायरली टेक 20 to 25 minutes. 20 minutes एटलीस्ट. आई एम ट्राइंग टू मेक यू एनालाइज दैट इफ यू डू नॉट हैव स्पीड, क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 विल टेक योर एटलीस्ट 20 minutes. ओके, टू सॉल्व. And bare minimum 5 minutes to read. So that will make how much? 25 minutes only for question number 1. That you agree? Question 1. Question 2. Suppose it has 4 marks ka question and 8 marks ka question. 4 marks ke question mein right now you have made 5 minutes. 8 marks ka question at least by reading and by writing at least 10 minutes. Double to karna hi padega. It is going to be 15 minutes. Theek hai? Question 3, at least 3 questions you would find, at least 3 will be there. If all the 3 are 4 marks, suppose all are 4 marks, still you need how many minutes? 15, as per your reading as well as your writing. Again, it is 15 minutes. Bhai, yahi pe tumhara kya ho jayega? Aadha kaam to yahi pe khatam ho jayega. Question number 4, again, it will have 4 parts. It will at least have 4 parts because question number 4 is tedious thesis. So it will at least have A, B, C, D, aise 4 parts honge. So assuming ki again 5 minutes you will take for 4 parts, 20 hai. Half idhar, half almost idhar, 1 ghanta ho gaya, 20 idhar ho gaya. Then question number 5 and question number 6. Suppose again you will take 15 minutes here. That means 30 here. Overall total you should solve your paper in 2 hours. Ma'am, kaisi baat karo, 70 marks ka paper 2 hours mein hona chahiye. Hona hi chahiye. Why? Because now you have MCQ. MCQ mein you have at least 22 question. Kyun ma'am 22? Kyun 30 marks ka aata na? Case study has 2 marks. Case study ke every MCQ has 2 marks. So I am assuming to read that MCQs, you will spend not more than 15 minutes. पूरे अगर एमसीक्यू भी केस स्टडी भी रीड आउट करोगे एटलीस्ट यू नीड 15 मिनट्स यस और नो एम आई गोइंग बियॉन्ड समथिंग नहीं 15 मिनट्स ओवरऑल इधर उधर रीडिंग में निकलना ही है तो 2 hours तो ऑलरेडी आई नीड फॉर 70 मार्क्स का डिस्क्रिप्टिव देन 15 मिनट्स फॉर एमसीक्यू रीडिंग ठीक है देन टिक करना ये वो तो एटलीस्ट 15 टू 20 मिनट्स टू थिंक एंड टू करेक्ट So, are you getting 2 hours, 15 minutes, and this is 20, that is coming to be 2 hours 30 minutes. Actually, the paper is designed for 2.5 hours. The paper is entirely decided for 2.5 hours. What are that extra timing, extra 20 minutes or your timing is only to read the paper, to analyze your mistake, your presentation, everything. So, basically, ये मैंने बहुत बेयर मिनिमम लिया है यू आर गेटिंग दिस थिंग इट इज बेयर मिनिमम 5 मिनट्स आई हैव अलॉटेड फॉर 4 मार्क्स का क्वेश्चन एंड दिस स्पीड यू हैव टू इंक्रीज बिकॉज दिस डायरेक्ट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन विल नॉट कम इन योर एग्जाम ऐसे डायरेक्ट तो आने वाले नहीं इफ यू आर स्पेंडिंग इवन 10 मार्क्स इन अ क्वेश्चन तुम देख लो जैसे ही मैंने 10 मिनट्स कर दिया एक क्वेश्चन में ये पूरा टाइम क्या हो जाएगा चेंज हो जाएगा We have gone bare minimum 5 minutes we have allotted to all the types of question 5 minutes just question number 1 ko I have given 25 minutes uske baad tum khud hi dekh lo na it is going like even a single minute you are wasting idhar udhar or if you have allotted 4 marks ke question pe 10 minutes 101% paper kya hoga complete nahi hoga so if you want to run a race यहाँ पे लिखने की प्रैक्टिस तो चाहिए एंड वी एज अ सी ए स्टूडेंट वी डू रीडिंग वी डू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट वी फेल टू लर्न एबीसीडी यू नेवर फॉरगेट व्हाई यू हैव इन योर लॉन्ग टर्म मेमोरी टिल चाइल्डहुड यू आर डूइंग दैट बट इफ आफ्टर 1 month आई विल आस्क यू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ दिस अप्पा आई कैन राइट इट राइट नाउ यू विल फॉरगेट क्यों बिकॉज नाउ यू आर नॉट लर्निंग You are just आगे आ गया अब समझ में आ गया बाद में कर लेंगे We will do by ourselves once the class will end. After the end of the class, it will be restart. You can ask your friends, n number of students. Percentage of failure is not because the course is so much, because in that 1.5 day, you fail to revise, and the confidence you lose on 1 day before exam. The major reason once you lose the confidence, your brain thinks ki mujhe nahi aane wala, mujhe yaad bhi nahi aayega. I will not be able to recall the things. Aur jahan usko ye samajh mein aage nahi, to wo 3 hours tumhare panic wale hi honge. And in 3 hours, if you find out of the box paper, what I have revised, it is not coming. Next attempt mein aayenge. Aur yahi hota hai. So major reason for failure is not because the course is tough. Tough reason is you are unable to complete your paper. Is it 400 ka paper total 400? What you want 200, right? I can say ki suppose 90 marks ka paper you attempt. Everyone attempted 90 marks ka paper. That means out of 360 you have to score 200. If 10 marks also you have gone, you have lost. That means 360 में से 200 चाहिए वो 40 मार्क्स किसी में पास होने के लिए हो जाते हैं जो 40 मार्क्स गए अंडरस्टूड पहला सेकंड आर यू श्योर 90 में से 100% 90 का 100% इज करेक्ट सपोज उसमें से 10 का तो तुक्का लगा है जस्ट वी हैव ट्राइड टू सॉल्व 10 का ही ले रही हूं मैं आई एम नॉट टेकिंग मोर तो एवरी पेपर 10 वॉज लाइक कि वी डोंट नो द आंसर बट वी हैव अटेम्प्टेड Now you want to score from 320 से 200 चाहिए. Are you getting the reason why we fail? 20 marks I have reduced from every paper. Only 20 marks. And now it is 320 से मैम हमको क्या चाहिए? 200 चाहिए. Now what about 10 तो गया because we are unable to attempt. 10 इसलिए गया we attempted but we don't know the answer. Third. Suppose for the timing, only 10 marks ka is wrong. Only according to you, 10 मार्क्स का आंसर बिल्कुल रॉन्ग है, मुझे पता है कि कट जाएंगे मार्क्स. आर यू गेटिंग व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से? नाउ एवरी पेपर 30 मार्क्स आई एम रिड्यूसिंग. सो एवरी पेपर 30 मार्क्स मतलब 120 यू हैव टू सबट्रैक्ट. 400 में से 120 सबट्रैक्ट करोगे, अब 200 कितने में से चाहिए? 280. Now you have to score from 280 to 200. So are you getting why it is failure? Now you are assuming ki 10 marks ka galat hai. Now paper checker unable to understand your language. They do not find keywords. Unko keywords nahi mile. Unko language samajhni hai. Benefit is SFM, rounding off ki error. Wo sari faltu ki error. 10 marks paper checker ki taraf se samajh lo, tumhare jaane hi hai. Jaane hi hai wo to. Actually 240 में से you have to get 200. That is the reason when aggregate नहीं होता है, because paper complete नहीं किया, you have not written 100%, conceptual clarity नहीं है. That means cutthroat competition चल रहा है. It is not from 400 you have to score 200. It is at least bare minimum 280 में से you have to score, and if I am going to most least 240 में से you have to score 200. And for that, do writing practice. Because once you have done writing practice, if you have attempted na 100 marks ka paper, at least for 40 marks you will save. Main nahi bolti 40 out of 40 you will get in that. Agar 10 bhi aa gaye na, to ho sakta hai 190 se you will be at 200. Are you getting the logic? So there are lots of reason for failure. Once you understand one thing, in any class you understand the concept, but me as a teacher, because I am checking your copy, so I will get to know कि अच्छा ये तुम गलत समझ रहे हो. But when it is bulk, you don't know कि बच्चा समझ क्या रहा है. तुमने तो समझा दिया, हमने समझा दिया, मुझे नहीं पता what you understand, what you write, and what you interpreted. So for that, first of all, I have explained you the concept. Do reading important. मैम क्यों reading? Because this reading will help you in increasing your reading practice. Second, learn it like a child that you used to do earlier in your 6, 7, 8 time. Learn it अच्छे से so that your head will know कि okay ये learn किया, and then do revision. Only 3 things: read, understand, learn, and then at least one time write it so that you will know कि language लिखनी क्या है. Okay, so that was I wanted to give. यही रीजन मैं लिखवा रही हूँ टू लेट यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस इज द टाइम कैलकुलेशन एंड दिस इज द टाइम मैनेजमेंट यू नेवर डू बट दैट इज नीडेड. सो दैट्स व्हाई रिवाइज प्रॉपरली, राइट प्रॉपरली. ओके, सो टुडे वी हैव डन अप्पा का कॉन्सेप्ट, बट नाउ इन अप्पा का सम एलिमेंट्री पॉइंट्स दे हैव एडेड व्हाट सम एलिमेंट्री पॉइंट्स. सो टुमारो वी विल कंप्लीट अप्पा प्राइमरी सेकेंडरी एडजस्टमेंट, एंड वंस वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टुमारो का क्लास majority part transfer pricing end. Only what is left, country by country reporting, penalty, and one more little bit thing, that is master file. Ye teen concept bachte, that is particularly theory, no logic at all. So I can say day after tomorrow transfer pricing will end. One day we will spend for entire question solving, and then it will be a surprise test. Never ever I will take you a प्री पेपर टाइम माइंड टेस्ट की मैं बता रही हूँ कि अब मैं टेस्ट लूंगी. इट विल ऑलवेज बी अ सरप्राइज टेस्ट. दैट मींस यू हैव टू अटेंड रिवीजन, यू हैव टू बी प्रिपेयर कि कभी भी एग्जाम आएगी तो वी विल बी एबल टू राइट. ओके, सो बी प्रिपेयर. ठीक है, डन. बस सरप्राइज टेस्ट का टाइमिंग आई विल डिसाइड विथ यू कि वॉट टाइम यू वुड बी सबमिटिंग मी दैट आंसर शीट. ठीक है, चलो. So connect, we will connect tomorrow again at same time. Any doubt in APPA till now, and which book you are having as a reference book, what you are having, handwritten notes I will give, but what you have, any book?
BB compact theory.
Everyone having BB sir compact book. Saladi, you if you do not have, so I would suggest ki purchase compact. So whenever I would like to refer anything or I would to do na analysis ki idhar se ye le lo, so we will use compact book. Theek hai, question bank is going is in the process of amendment, so in 7 days you will get my question bank. But international taxation there is no amendment, so that will be provided to you. Theek hai, that I will provide ek saath mein, but this handwritten charts every chapter I am writing, so that along with the chapter I will be providing you the handwritten charts. Okay. ठीक है, तो जस्ट परचेस कॉम्पैक्ट बुक, बीबी सर की ओनली कॉम्पैक्ट बुक, डू नॉट परचेस कंपाइलर, ओनली कॉम्पैक्ट बुक. ठीक है, चलो, ओके, वी विल कनेक्ट.
मैम वन सेकंड,
वन मिनट.